There's definitely a strong need for higher energy density, longer lasting and safer batteries for drones, wearables, consumer electronics, and ultimately electric cars. And I think if we can meet these milestones, it was a way to make an impact on society. The research lab that I was working at, they were working on rechargeable lithium metal batteries. And it was very safe, had very high energy density, but it had a shortcoming, and that was it would only work at high temperature. We noticed that at that time there were breakthroughs in other fields. We decided we could actually integrate these breakthroughs in a way that this battery would now function at room temperature. MIT asked the people from the science and engineering school to pitch ideas in energy. I pitched mine, and then it was the most, well-received, and we immediately formed a team around it.
We are Solid Energy, and we make the world's safest battery.
We got a lot of support from investors, strategic, financial. We did really well. And then all of a sudden, a lot of the major battery companies in the US, they went bankrupt. That made everything really difficult in terms of starting a battery company. The team that I had, they dissipated. Everyone just left. Then that was really hard. There was just something in me that I just really liked about this technology, and I just wanted to pursue this. So that happened in August, and then that October, I met a surfing instructor. So I remember something that he said that I still remember today. He said, "Surfing small waves is about how you perform when everything goes right. Surfing big waves is about how you perform when everything goes wrong." And that gave me a lot of confidence to just stick with it. I realized that I had to be more resourceful. We were going to A123, a battery company based in Massachusetts. They had just gone through bankruptcy, so the whole building was very much empty. But they still have very nice facilities, very nice equipment. We basically just walked up to a guy that was just sitting there and not doing anything, and they asked if he could teach us how to build some batteries and use the facilities. Initially, he laughed. He thought we were just some students that were lost in a school field trip. Eventually, he told us how to run the whole line. It was a fantastic opportunity. I had access to all this nice equipment facility, and all for free, at least in the beginning. We developed some materials at MIT, and then we went there to build batteries. So I went there as often as possible, on weekends, evenings, as often as basically they were open. In about 2 years, we built our first prototype. It's about the same capacity as an iPhone 6 battery, but half the size. And this is not on paper, not on simulation. This is a real battery. And we send this battery to third parties, to strategic partners for testing, and they all came back really excited. We just finished construction of our brand new facility, and we'll be producing this technology at a pilot scale. I think nowadays with smart communication and then cleaner transportation, the battery is the limiting factor. And a lot of the companies that are developing smarter devices and electric cars, they're facing this hurdle, and someone needs to solve this hurdle. And I think Solid Energy is in a good position to solve this and then make an impact on society. You know.